Let's just pull out the front row seats right there real quick, Jim. We're going to send you right down to the very front. We're going to pop out one of those seats right there for you.
Good afternoon. I am Pastor Chuck Rager, and I welcome you to our services today for Terry Ogle. I would ask if you have any cell phones, if you would please turn them to off or silent at this time out of respect for the occasion to which we find ourselves gathered. Let us begin with a word of prayer. Gracious God, we invite your Holy Spirit to come and to be a part of our gathering this afternoon. I ask that you extend comfort and peace and strength to all who are assembled here. May your Spirit move among us, encourage us, and help us during this time of loss and sorrow. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. The first scripture passage I have for today comes from the Gospel of John in the third chapter. Jesus is speaking, and begins the passage in this manner. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know, and we testify to what we have seen. But still you people do not accept our testimony. I have spoken to you of earthly things, and you do not believe. How then will you believe if I speak of heavenly things? No one has ever gone into heaven except the one who came from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son. This is the verdict. Light has come into the world, but people love darkness instead of light because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light for fear that their deeds will be exposed. But whoever lives by the truth comes into the light so that it may be seen plainly what they have done has been done in the sight of God. Amen. At this time, we will hear the song, Who You Say I Am.
There's no wall you won't kick down.
Ogle was born October 25th, 1957, in Maywood, California, to his parents Al and Beverly Ogle. He grew up with his brother Richard and his sisters Nancy and Connie. The Ogle family moved from California to Alliance, Nebraska, where Terry attended school, and he graduated from Alliance High School. Terry married Frances Mart, and they initially made their home in Alliance for years, where Terry worked at various jobs in that area. They were blessed with two sons, Alexander and Jeremy. In 2006, they moved to Ogallala, and Terry began working for ASC, where he had been working for several years. He was well-liked at ASC and was a key member of the company. In his 9 working hours, Terry enjoyed fishing, especially fishing for bass. He loved to tell stories, sometimes about himself and his life experiences, and he loved it when his stories made you laugh. He was a big follower of the Cornhuskers and had been for many years. He enjoyed playing Kingdoms of Camelot. Seafood was among his favorite dining interests. Terry was a hard-working man who loved his family and loved his friends. Terry's mom and dad traveled on ahead of him from this earthly journey. Among those who continue this earthly journey without him are his wife Frances, his son Alex and his wife Jamie, his son Jeremy and his wife Leslie, his brother Richard and his wife Annette, his sister Nancy and her husband Roger, his sister Connie and her husband Dave, and his grandchildren Layla, Maya, Olivia, Gage, Balak, and Zion. Today we gather together to remember Terry, to give thanks for the love and the friendship he shared with those around him, and to remember and give thanks for the love and the grace and the eternal life that is offered to all through our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Terry Ogle. Our second scripture passage today comes from 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 6 through 8. Let us hear these words. For I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time for my departure is near. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. At this time we'll hear the song, Reckless Love.
I'm a child.
reading from the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for the Lord is with me. His rod and his staff, they comfort me. The Lord prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies, and he anoints my head with oil so that my cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. As we gather together today, we come to remember Terry and to be able to cherish and to hold those memories of him that are yours to have and to hold. And as we remember Terry, we think of those things that are part and parcel of who he is. We remember that he loves to fish. And a good day out on that boat fishing for bass was a good day. We remember that when it came time to eat, that one of his favorite things to eat was seafood. And we remember that he loves to tell stories. Stories about himself, stories about his life and adventures. And if his stories made you smile or laugh or giggle, all the better. And we remember that he loves his family. And he loves his friends. And today, with the help of Scripture, we remember some more things. I read that passage from the Gospel of John in the 3rd chapter. And it helps us to remember that God loves us. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have eternal life." Let us be quick to note that that passage does not tell us that our earthly body will not die. That passage says that if we believe in Jesus, we need not perish. We need not cease to exist. That through our faith in him and his grace and his power and his glory, that when this earthly body dies, we transition into a new body, and we continue to live in the presence of God forever and ever. And then that passage from 2 Timothy, it helps us to remember that promise of grace and of love that is offered to all. 2 Timothy, written by the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul knew he was at the end of his earthly journey. So he wrote this letter specifically for Timothy, but he knew fully well that others would hear and read his words. And knowing that the time for his earthly leaving had come, Paul wrote the words and says, "The time for my departure has come." But what's really fascinating about that passage and what drew me to it for today is that Paul wrote those words in Greek. And if we translate literally, word for word, what he wrote, it would not read, "The time for my departure has come." It would read, "The time for my loosing has come." You see, loosing was a sailing term. It was a boating phrase. It meant that you would loose the ropes and the knots that tied your boat to the dock here and allowed you to set sail and go somewhere else. And in my mind's eye, when I read that scripture, I pictured Terry out there in his boat, loosing the ropes and getting ready to sail out to go fishing. But what that scripture helps us remind us of is this, that when we believe in Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, and when we accept his grace, that when the time comes for our loosing to life on this earth, that we loose the ropes and we set sail from life on the dock of earth, and we set sail to arrive in the dock of the kingdom of heaven, where we would dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. The time for Terry's loosing had come. And then in the 23rd Psalm, we remember the love and the grace and the glory of God as well. The psalmist said, "The Lord is my shepherd, and even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for the Lord is with me." And that passage helps us to remember that if we believe in Jesus Christ, that we can indeed walk through the valley of the shadow of death and continue to live in a new body and dwell in the presence of God forever and ever. But it also gives us a reminder and draws our attention to the fact that just as the Lord offers to walk with us through that valley of the shadow of death, that prior to that big valley, the Lord offers to walk with us through all the smaller valleys of life that come before the big valley. The Lord offers to walk with you through times of sorrow and pain and loss and confusion. And so today, if you find yourself in one of those valleys, know that the same Lord who will walk with you through the valley of the shadow of death will walk through you through the valleys of sorrow and loss. And so today is a time to remember. We remember Terry, we remember his love for fishing, we remember the love and the stories he shared with those around him, and we remember the offer of love and grace and life that is extended to all through our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. In his name, amen. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Gracious God, we give you thanks for the life that Terry lived here on this earth. And Lord, I ask that you please walk with each of these persons. Walk with them through these valleys. Let them feel your comfort, your presence, and your strength. Guide them, help them, love them, care for them, please. And may they have the memories of Terry to cherish and to hold from this day forth. Bless them and keep them in your care. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Receive the benediction. May the sun shine warmly upon your face. May the breeze blow gently upon your back, and may the presence of God abide with you today, tomorrow, and always. Go in Christ's name. Amen. Thank you.